Disgraced town mayor Alice Guo expected to be flown home Thursday evening from Indonesia. That information coming from Senator Raffi Tulfo. Guo's lawyer Stephen David also saying it is highly likely that his client will be brought back to the country later today. Guo will be accompanied by Interior Secretary Benhur Abalosan, Philippine National Police Chief Romel Marbil, who are now in Jakarta to facilitate her return to Manila. Reports earlier surfaced Indonesia is seeking a prisoner swap between Guo and an Australian man wanted in Jakarta on drug trafficking charges. But the Philippine Justice Department says Guo's arrest is just the beginning of uncovering the expansive criminal activities of illegal offshore gaming operators in the country.
Alice Guo is just one piece of the puzzle. We need to piece up the entire picture for us to be able to really dig down deep and be able to bring into the light, so to speak, and resolve all the problems head on for the betterment. Alice Guo is just one step. It's a big step, yes, but she's not the end all and be all. There's a bigger, much bigger problem, and she's just the tip of the iceberg.
Guo's lawyers have welcomed her arrest but remain firm their client is innocent until proven otherwise. Attorney Stephen David also saying Wesley Guo already wants to surrender and that they're already coordinating with authorities regarding this. Senator Risa Ontiveros optimistic government will soon see the full extent of the criminal activities of POGOs with the arrest of Alice Guo. Senate Committee on Ways and Means Chairman Sherwin Gachelian said the Senate is set to hold another hearing on September 9, and they expect Alice Guo to be present to answer their questions.
Slowly, we are seeing the full extent of the criminal activities of this sham and dismissed mayor. At malapit na rin nating maungkat kung sino-sino ang mga tumulong, nagpayaman, nag-enable, at sa mga nakalipas na buwan at linggo, kumupkop sa kanya.
So meron kami pa isang hearing this coming itong darating na Lunes, at ito ay ginawa para talaga sa kanya, no? Itong hearing sa Lunes ay gagawin para kay Guo Huaping.
And let's get an update now on government's efforts to bring back Alice Guo from Indonesia. Our very own Zian Ambrosio now joins us from Jakarta for that. Zian, over to you.
Carmina, at 1 a.m., members of the Bureau of Immigration and the National Bureau of Investigation, along with the Philippine media, arrived at the Jakarta airport, while at 3 a.m., Interior Local Government Secretary Benhur Abalos and PNP Chief Romel Marbil arrived via a chartered flight here in Jakarta, Indonesia. According to the Bureau of Immigration, they are expecting to turn over dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Guo from the Indonesian counterparts this afternoon to the Philippine authorities. Anytime from now, Carmina, SILG Abalos and PNP Chief Romel Marbil will be arriving at the DIV Hubinter, or the Indonesian police, here in Jakarta. BI officials said they discovered that Guo booked from one hotel to another in Jakarta to hide from authorities. The news team is expecting to get a chance to see and interview former Mayor Alice Guo during the turnover to Philippine authorities. We are still checking, Carmina, if Mayor Guo will be able to go back to Manila tonight. And that's the latest here in Jakarta, Indonesia. Zian Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News.
Yes, Zian, just a couple of questions for you before we let you go. First off, there are conflicting reports as to who was with Alice Guo when she was apprehended. May kasama ba siya or wala?
Carmina, from what we learned from the Bureau of Immigration, she was just by herself when she was arrested by the Indonesian police. So we are still verifying that because according to the BI, they also discovered that there are some policemen, there are some Chinese suspects allegedly who are coordinating with Alice Guo in order to escape from authorities. Mm-hmm. Carmina.
And the turnover, as you were mentioning a while ago, that's expected to happen at what time?
The turnover is expected to happen at around 1 p.m. So we are on our way there, Carmina. So mm-hmm. I am now with the Bureau of Immigration and the NPI heading towards the DIV Hubinter, or the police station here in Indonesia. Carmina.
All right. Thanks a lot. Our very own Zian Ambrosio there joining us on the phone from Jakarta in Indonesia. The head of the Philippine gaming regulator says an executive order outlining the phased shutdown of offshore gaming operators by year end will be released released within the month. PACOR Chairman Alejandro Otenco says some POGOs have already begun the process of closing down. He notes foreign POGO workers will be departing in batches. They will be given until October 15 to voluntarily downgrade their work visas to tourist visas. President Marcos, in his third State of the Nation address, ordered a total ban on POGOs, citing their links to crime and human rights abuses.